both teams getting their final warm-ups in as we welcome you back to the MLB pregame show. First pitch of Game 2 in our series is right around the corner, but before we turn that corner, here is our Topps player spotlight. Matt Meyer will be our focus. Coming off a last game in which he was really outstanding in the clutch moments, collecting a whole bucket full of RBI, so he'll be looking to emulate that type of performance here again in this one.
Yeah, and you said it, Matt. He was clutch. And you know, some guys just have that uncanny ability to come through when it really matters. In baseball, it's usually when there are runners in scoring position, and he found himself up in that situation a number of times. It was pretty special to watch him out there, so I'm excited to see what he does to back it up.
All right, lineups and first pitch are coming up next. Stay tuned for that right here on the show.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube. We are, of course, in the Matt Meyer Road of the Show series. You see that by the intro here. I've got a special guest today. It's my buddy, Mr. Hurricane. How are you doing, sir?
I'm doing great. We're here for some Matt Meyer Road to the Show today.
That's
getting
right.
Getting ready for his first at-bat.
He's actually here for Mad Mania, but we're doing some baseball first. And, he crushed that.
We got a Meyer moonshot to kick this one off, going all the way to space and back down to Earth.
Nice call. All right. Even knew my call. Yeah, by the way, go get your Meyer moonshot t-shirts over at my Spreadshirt shop. I'll maybe put the link in here in the description.
I'll remind him.
That's
no excuses.
Right. Yeah, there you go. I wore mine to the State Fair the other day, Minnesota State Fair.
So how many home runs on the year is that for Matt Meyer?
I believe that is number 30. I think that was a milestone shot right there.
And how far are we into the season? I missed the records.
We're just after the All-Star break a bit. So, I mean, he's on a good pace. Not like record pace, but for his second full year in the bigs, I think this is. That's quite a good pace. He's up there in all the Triple Crown categories. I don't think he's on top of any of them, but he's there. Another base hit right there.
Now, has he been tested for any illegal substances lately?
Well, I know the viewers kind of bring that up from time to time, and I think officially...
No, he actually looks like a pretty lean guy.
You know what? He was kind of a big dude, and people didn't like that. They're like, no, he's too fat. Make him smaller. And so I caved. I found a storyline angle that I was able to do that. He came into his second season leaner and meaner. And it's showing up, I guess, in the home runs and stuff. So it paid off. I guess they're right. But they're never going to let me or get me to make Champ Kind that way. He's always going to be the pudgy.
Bottom of the ninth inning.
Look at that.
Oh, my goodness.
All that damage he did and still he couldn't get it done. And the Yankees are terrible in this game. They have, 37 and 60. We have no business losing that game, and yet we did. But there it was, 30th home run on the season. 30 Meyer moonshots so far. And we're going to play another game in this Yankees series. See if we can actually beat him once. Be nice. So I think we are about four games out of first place right now. Just kind of this AL West is always tough. That guy booted that. That was no good. So he's on with a infield error there.
That was a little too close.
Yeah, this is definitely not my speed guy. That's for sure. He doesn't, I think he's maybe got one career stolen base. And look at that. He bobbled that out and left, though. And he's got some savvy coming around the bases, though. He knew when to
no hesitation. If he did, he'd been out.
That's right. So, actually, it was kind of funny because I was just waiting to see if he'd field it. And he had pretty good reaction to it there. Now here's the real test. Can he tag up and score on this? Let's see here. Throw from left, and he's not that deep. But that throw wasn't very good either. Scores, and he gets a boatload of points on the base pass, so that's always cool for a guy who doesn't steal bases. But he went from first to third and then tagged up. So 2-1 lead, runners at the corners. Ooh, that's got a chance. Is he going to get out of here? Nope.
Off the wall.
But look at that now. He thinks he's just got a single. He's going to sit there. And then he decides to hustle in for a double.
Luckily, the runner was going to third, and that allowed him to get the second base.
I think I might have forced him to do that. I don't know. Sometimes, though, like in previous years, you could totally force him to go. Sometimes this year, they're just like, nope. I'm staying here. It's another base hit. Nobody on third, so that won't be an RBI. But that's third. No, the first one was an error. So what do you get?
No
two hits
in the batting race at all?
Yeah, it's actually going to show a graphic here somewhere later on in the episode. He's like third, fourth in the batting race. But as you'll find out, I think it's Mauer is just like Mauer's with the Blue Jays, which is weird. But he's somewhere up around 370. So it's going to be a tough climb if he's going to try to get that leg of the Triple Crown. So we're back in the division, but we do have that top wild card spot right now, And it's all about the AL West because the Athletics have the other one to date.
Hey,
so
don't cut off those Minnesota Twins.
I know, right? Yeah, I think they're way behind in this. When we played at Target Field, there were, I think, exactly 15 people in the crowd. So it's starting to look realistic. But
after a while, that new stadium charm wears off.
Yeah, it does. I mean, although I'm hoping the serve your own beer stand is going to bring some people back. They put that in right before the All-Star game. I tried to get at that machine during the home run derby, and it was just way too crowded. I'm like, I'll go back when nobody's here again. But there you go. Oh, that's the RBI leaders. Okay, so he's second in RBIs. Trumbo plays for the
Does that include the one
Twins
he just got?
No, that says entry and play. So that probably one closer. That was probably 84. And it's a 1-1 game in the third here now. And, oh, that breaking pitch.
Oh, he hung that one.
Yeah. See, that at-bat was actually kind of nice because he had to work a bunch of pitches, follow him off, and he finally got one that hung over the plate there. Meyer Moonshot, number 31 on the season. Yeah,
not sure that one grazed the moon. But.
Yeah, no, that wasn't one of his longer shots, but there was a 4-pitch at-bat. And so you get some more points for seeing some pitches there. And you got just enough of it to get it out of there. And he didn't get to do a bat flip or anything on that occasion because
Got that Yasiel Puig yet?
Yeah, no, not quite. And let's see, but he's accounted for all their runs so far. This he's gonna have to use his foot speed, which he doesn't have, but he beats it out
somehow.
Infield base hit. So yeah, he's a catcher, but he hasn't been catching all year because they brought some hotshot catcher in. It was like a 90 overall. But he went on the disabled list, so now I'm back to catching after the All-Star break.
Maybe there's more to that story. How did he get on the disabled list?
No comment. I don't know. he might have gotten what was her name, the skater that took the club to the knee. There might have been something like that happening in the clubhouse. Meyer might have hit a Meyer Moonshot on his teammate. But that's just speculation. I don't know if that really went down or not. Meyer, your player of the game, and he should have been because he had both RBIs on the day in a 2-1 ball game, including the home run. Yes, sir. So, I don't know what the deal was. I mean, he obviously wasn't really happy when he showed up to spring training, and all of a sudden this guy comes out of nowhere and takes his job. Essentially made him the DH all year. So, I mean,
that's not
he's
too bad.
Yeah, I mean, he's lucky he's on an AL club because he could just sit around and be a DH all year. And, I mean, really.
And extend his career by like 5 years.
They're going to pay you to do that. You might as well, right? So it's a 2-1 victory. We got a trade. It's not involving Matt Meyer, but they're bringing a third baseman in. Hey, come on. We've got Danny Valencia. What do we need that for?
Oh, no.
75 overall, Danny Valencia. He does. He holds his own in here. All right. So
is this a pitcher that was expendable?
I guess, because I've never seen that guy in a game in my life. But, of course, I don't get to see the closing opportunities anyway when they don't show them to me, really. But
this is a big series. It's only a 4-game difference.
Yeah. I mean, we're right neck and neck with these guys. I mean, in the second and third place. And there's another early RBI in the game, so that'll help his almost league-leading totals there. And
close
I think
to 90.
Yeah, one of these times they're going to show us where he is in the batting average race, too. I swear it was in here, so I'm just kind of waiting for that. But one of these graphics will show it. I think he's like third place, but it's a big gap between second and first. Base is loaded here. That's going to be up the middle, and they have troubles with that. Long story short, he's going to score on the play. They do get an out at first base. And he's got to be careful. Every time they walk through that on-deck circle, the guy keeps swinging. And one of these guys is going to get clubbed. So down 5-4, but two runners on. Get out of here, please. Yes, three-run homer. Opposite field, Meyer Moonshot, number 32. And it came at a great time. Yeah, all right. So three-run homer. Come on, get around the bases. Thank you. 38 points. And that puts him in the lead, I do believe. We were down 5-4. It's a 7-5 game now. As he continues to show that opposite field power. 32 homers now.
His last two homers, though, barely cleared the fence. Is he losing his touch a little bit?
I don't know. I think he's just kind of taking it easy. I think, like you touched on earlier, he might be a little worried. He's going to have a sample waiting for him when he gets back to his locker stall. He doesn't want to.
Uh-oh, Barry Bonds.
Oh, look at that. They're going to walk him. So I think the thing to watch, though, is if his hat size doubles soon, there might be some concern. You know, if he comes out for his next game looking like John Cena or something, then maybe there'll be some concern. But they come back and tie this. Now it's 7-7 in the ninth. Now it's funny. I have my fielding set to some chances, and when it's a catcher, it's all or nothing. So if you do all, you got to catch every pitch. If you do some, you get pop ups, you get bunts, and you get to try to throw people out at second base. That's basically what you do.
So it gets under this one.
Yeah, he was hoping to maybe have a repeat performance, but that's not getting out of here. And that was in extra innings. And unfortunately, the way this game works, if you don't come through in extra innings, usually the other team does in a big way, and they do. We lose 12-7 in, I think, 13 innings.
Ooh, 29 hits. You guys got your money's worth if you went to this one.
Yeah, yeah, that's your American League Baseball right there at its finest. So I think we got one more game to show in this series before this episode's over. So he's at, what did that say, 32 home runs? All right. So,
and Oakland just got a game back, so if they can get another one, that'll be pretty big in this race.
Yeah, so a little spotlight we're going to talk over this time. I'm not going to let it run the whole way. It's just another 4 RBI game. Ho-hum.
Just
ho-hum.
Another 4 RBI game.
But, you know, this one, he gets 2 RBI in the game before that. Okay, here. He leads the American League in home runs and RBI. But we never did get that graphic on where he is in the I swear I had that in here. Maybe I missed it. But rest assured, Mauer is like at 369 or something like that. So, I mean, he's a good 30 points above the competition. I think second place was like just above where Meyer's at. He hit that one hard, but it lined out to Reddick out there. I always want to call him J.J. Reddick. That's Josh Reddick. That's a different sport, of course. We're kind of having trouble as a team hitting in this game, and Meyer's no different. I think that makes it 0-4. And this isn't going to be good.
Kind of a disappointing game for him here.
Very disappointing after hitting all those home runs. Nope, Jared Parker shuts him down. And Yu Darvish, man, he has bad luck in this game. Although he gave up quite a few runs.
So the Athletics are now only down by one or two games after this shutout.
Yeah, look at that. Well, actually, how do we still have that? Wow, okay, the Mariners are doing well. We're 5.5 back. The A's are 8 back.
Oh, man,
neither one of us are doing
brutal.
That well. The Mariners always do good in video game baseball. I don't know why. In this game, they're just gangbusters. So that's going to do it. Thank you, Kane, for joining me. We'll see you next time, guys.
Goodbye.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!